Welcome to this week's episode of Brainstorm, where we give you a glimpse into the world of science for Thursday, January 9th, 2014. We begin with news from the world of medicine. A multi-institutional team of scientists have been studying gene networks to identify and target breast cancer. Since it is one of the most prevalent types of cancer, many are investigating ways of detecting and treating it early on. Some people with high risk are even undergoing surgery and treatment, even if they have only suspicious lumps that may not become cancerous, or in some cases, no sign of the disease at all. These preventative measures do alleviate the risk, but come with many unpleasant side effects. What this team is endeavoring to do is develop a gene-based therapy that can prevent cancer from forming or even reverse it in its early stages. This is in contrast to essentially all current cancer treatments, which try to kill cancer cells. To do this, they began looking at the genes that were more active when cells became cancerous, but it was more complicated than that. Hundreds of genes became more active, but since some genes activate others, they look at the network of activity as a whole. Eventually, they narrowed it down to 6 regulatory genes, and then further down to 1 single gene that seemed to promote cells to become cancerous. In cell cultures of humans and mouse cells, healthy milk duct cells formed hollow spheres, whereas cancer cells formed lumpy tumors. After they introduced a small piece of RNA to interfere with their target gene, the tumors reverted to a healthy state. Nanoparticles loaded with this RNA were also able to prevent breast cancer in a line of mice specifically designed to develop the disease. Obviously, more testing is needed before this could be applied to humans, but it is very encouraging. Treatments like this could be used to prevent cancer in high-risk individuals and even reverse it without surgery or harsh chemotherapy in some cases. This next story is actually somewhat similar but still very interesting from the world of genetics. Other researchers, mainly from Tel Aviv University, have been researching different ways to induce longevity similar to caloric restriction. Like the first story, these researchers used a computational model to identify certain genes of interest. Theirs not only modeled genes and how they are connected, but actually the entire metabolism of an organism. Because the hope is to eventually apply this research to humans, they used yeast as a model organism. It's relatively simple, and its biology is well understood, but it's still eukaryotic like multicellular humans. One of the researchers developed what is called a metabolic transformation algorithm, which is as cool as it sounds, and it should sound really cool, because they can target certain metabolic pathways known in the organism, input an altered state of those metabolic pathways, and the algorithm will identify genetic and environmental changes that would induce the desired change. The original metabolic state was an old yeast cell, and the target was a young yeast cell. The algorithm produced 7 potential genes, some of which were known from previous research, but a few new ones as well. Testing in actual yeast showed that 2 of them did significantly increase lifespan of the organisms. Next was some purely computational testing of the algorithm on models of human metabolism. It's encouraging as it was able to identify some genes already known about from previous work. Further experiments will be difficult, but the hope is to develop drugs that target these genes and alleviate age-related diseases. Well, hope you enjoyed this episode. In reference to both stories, what research would you do with the study of gene networks? Let us know your thoughts on that and all the stories in the comments.